Throughout this video series, I'm going to walk you through the whole process of setting up a website for yourself. But in this video, I want to take some time to let's talk about choosing the right platform for your website. I know that you're probably just gearing up and wanting to get started, and you just want to pick a website platform and just get going. But you really want to take just a few minutes to look at the different platforms that are out there and decide which one is right for you. When choosing the right platform, it's a good idea to maybe take out a piece of paper and pen and jot down some of the things that you're looking for in a website. If you're not sure what you need, then you can also look at your goals for your website and what the features you want your website to do. Some of the things you might be looking for between the different platforms could be price. Do they offer a trial account? Can you go in and create an account and take it for a test drive to see if it's going to be what you need? What are some of the features that they offer, and are they what you need? Some examples could be, do you want a blog section? Do you need a photo gallery? Do you need an online store or maybe a reservation system? Think about the features that you're looking for in your website, and are those available in the platform that you're looking at? Also look at growth options. Yeah, you're just starting out right now and you're probably looking at what you can do right now, and that's really important. But then once you become more established, will this website be able to grow with you? Will you be able to add things like an e-commerce store later on? Will you be adding regular updates to your website? Will you be selling more products? So you want to make sure that the platform allows you to grow as your business grows. So the first one we want to talk about is, let's discuss WordPress.org. The self-hosted WordPress powers over between 28 and 33% of the top websites out there at the time of this video recording. So it's a really popular and robust system. And when you hear WordPress, there are two different versions and we'll cover both of them. The one I'm talking about with this one is the WordPress.org. And then later on, I'll discuss WordPress.com. The self-hosted WordPress tops our list of most popular solutions simply because of its features, the functionality, the stability, and security that you have with it. It's an open source, meaning that it is free for you to use the software, and you also have the maximum control over what you do with your website. Because you have ultimate control and it's free to use the software, you will need a hosting provider to put the software on it. And the hosting provider provides the servers for you, so you don't have a server in your back room running for you that you have to worry about a server as well. So some of the pros for that is obviously pretty much absolutely anything that you can think of to do on your website, you can do with WordPress. There is usually a plugin. A plugin is like an app that extends the functionality of your website. There's probably a plugin that's already out there and it's probably free or low cost solution that you can install on your website. Things like adding an e-commerce store to your website, that is done by a plugin. So out of the box, being able to make your website do exactly what you want is available with WordPress with a little bit of setup. Along with the plugins or extending the functionality, there are thousands upon thousands of themes out there. The theme is the look and feel of your website, and there are a range of free and premium themes that you can purchase to make your website look and feel exactly how you want. Now, on the flip side, there are some cons. The biggest con is the fact that you will be handling all of this yourself. You have to get the hosting server package to put the software of WordPress on there, and then you're required to maintain that. And for some people, they just don't want that burden of maintaining it. You'll also be required to make sure that the updates are done, the plugins are updated, and that the backups are done. If you get the right hosting provider, then they can do a lot of that for you. And it's built into the pricing. So talking about pricing, the pricing structure of the software itself is actually free. Again, because you have to do a hosting provider, you have to buy a hosting provider package, that can range between, it averages about $12.99. As a WP Beginner user, you're able to get a website for only $2.75 a month through Bluehost. If you'll click on the link below, we've set up a discount through them for you. And that comes with a free SSL certificate and a free domain name. But what I like about it is you can extend it as you need to. So you can be as inexpensive as you need to begin. And then as your site grows, you can grow with the complexity and the expenses with it. The next platform I want to talk about is Wix.com. This is a hosted platform, meaning They do the hosting, everything's through them. All you have to do is log in through one login area and they handle the servers and everything for you. So it's considered a fully hosted platform. You don't have to pay for hosting. You're simply paying for them to host it and for them to set up the software for you. You have your choice of several hundred templates that you can choose from and a little bit of functionality that's already set up. If you're just getting started, they do offer a free limited plan, but obviously you can use this to test drive your idea to see if it's going to work for you. Now, the free plan doesn't include your own domain name, so it would be something like yoursite.wix.com, so keep that in mind. You also get a free SSL certificate with that, but you'll have to turn it on as well. Some of the cons for Wix are some of the lower tier, like the free and connect domain plans, will show the Wix branding on your site. They'll also show ads on your site, and you don't get the ad money. They will get that instead. Also, we've had several people move from Wix, and when moving from Wix, it can be quite tedious and almost impossible to do. Their pricing tiers are a little bit different. They range from $9 a month up to $26.25 a month if you want to add e-commerce. Also, their Connect domains, you'll still have to get your own domain for that. Shopify is a great e-commerce platform. So if you're looking to build up an e-commerce store, then this is a great solution for you. Their whole platform is built around e-commerce. So from the ground up, it's directed at building products and showing products to users. There are several themes to choose from. There are also several third-party apps that you can integrate with your site. And the same as with Wix, it is a hosted platform, so they host everything for you, and all you have to do is log in to your Shopify account to get started. For payments, they allow Shopify payments as well as third-party, and your own gateways are accepted through there, which is great. They have a website builder. Shopify comes with a full inventory management system for you to keep track of all of your inventory. For themes, they have several hundred themes to choose from, both free and paid. And they have a decent intuitive drag and drop system when you're wanting to change up your theme to match what you want your site to look like. So some of the cons for this is if you're just starting out, then it will be a little pricey. It's higher than most other websites. Speaking of pricing, it comes at $29 a month, and that's for the base amount. And then if you want to upgrade, you'll have to go up to $79 a month for the advanced. Shopify is also $299 a month. They'll do a light plan, which I've tried that before, and it's only $9 a month, but basically that just allows you to add products onto your own site. So you don't really get the inventory and the back end stuff. You just are able to add products to a site that you already have. It's a great way to test out if you're wanting to get into e-commerce, and then move up is what I recommend doing. Also, if you ever want to move away from Shopify, it's pretty difficult to move all of your stuff over from Shopify to another hosting platform. The next platform I want to talk about is Weebly. Like the other hosted platforms, this is a hosted platform. All you do is log in and you set up your account and you start creating your website. They have a drag and drop feature that allows you to make your website look and feel however you want. They have several website designs and you can do a drag and drop to make it look exactly how you want. It also has a built-in support for e-commerce through Square. And this allows you to start an online store and start selling pretty quickly. There are several built-in features automatically, such as contact form, photos, sliders, and things like that. Some of the cons for this is it's a fully hosted platform, so the features that are available are the only ones that they offer. In other words, you can't hire a developer or you can't code your own stuff into it if you need a different functionality for your site. The other thing is Weebly charges a 3% transaction fee on every purchase made through your e-commerce store. If you want to avoid those transaction fees, then you'll have to upgrade to their business plan. Some of their pricing is that Weebly is free to start off with, just like with Wix, but it's like yoursite.weebly.com. And their paid plans will start from $8 a month, billed annually, or $12 a month if you're billed monthly. Then their business plan costs $25 a month to get started. And then same with Wix, you'll also have to purchase your domain name separately. The next platform is Squarespace, and this is probably one of the most popular of the hosted platforms that there are, aside from WordPress.com. Squarespace has enterprise level infrastructure and hosting, so you can focus on just growing your site and not having to worry about the server structure. There are several designs to get started, or themes, if you will. There's also a lot of third-party apps that extend the functionality as well. If you're looking to turn it into a store, they have e-commerce functionality that you can add to your site. Some of the cons include limited integrations with third-party services, and that could be a hurdle if you're wanting your site to do a certain thing. Might be difficult to find the integration that you're looking for. Their e-commerce plans only allow Stripe, Apple Pay, and PayPal for a payment, so you can't add your own gateway. For pricing, they're ranging between $12 a month and $18 a month, and then their online store starts at $26 and $40 a month. Again, with most of the others, you'll also have to get your own custom domain name separately. And then the final one that I want to discuss is the WordPress.com. I started off the video talking about WordPress.org, and there are some similarities between the two. They both are using the WordPress software. The difference is WordPress.com is the hosted platform. You, like with the other hosting solutions out there, you simply log in and you start building up your website. Obviously, the beauty of that is you don't have to worry about software or backups or WordPress updates. It gets taken care of for you. There are free and paid plans that you can choose from, and the set of features will be different for each plan that you're using. All plans will have several hundreds of free and paid themes that you can choose from, as well as some of the plugins that you might want. Some of the downsides for WordPress.com is you can't install custom plugins. There are certain premium themes that you cannot install unless you upgrade to their business plan. Also, the premium and lower plans don't include e-commerce. Also, if you're looking to earn money from ad networks, the lower plans don't allow ad network integrations either. As I said, the basic plan is free, but again, that'll be yoursite.wordpress.com, and personal plans start at $4 a month. Premium plans will go as much as $8.25 a month, and then your business plan will be $24.92 a month, billed annually. And then that business plan gives you the e-commerce add-on that you were looking for. After looking at all of the solutions, we think that WordPress.org is the best solution that beats them all in overall performance, ease of use, functionality, and the ability to extend your website to do what you want it to do. Now that we've gone through and chosen the right platform for our website, in the next video, I want to walk you through how to pick the right name for your website. So I'll see you in the next video. Did you learn today's video? If so, subscribe to our YouTube channel and we'll send more helpful tips to help you manage your WordPress website. And thanks for watching.